So what we're going to look for is we're going to look for a constant difference. That means our f of x is going to increase or decrease by the same amount. In other words, you're going to look for an adding or subtracting pattern, and that is always adding or subtracting the same number. That's it. As soon as you find that one of the numbers is off, it's not a constant difference anymore. So let's look at this one over here. And just noticing the numbers are going, my sequence is from 12 to 19 to 26 to 33. So I'm actually going to write this down here, just doing it this way, because I think it'll be helpful. And you can definitely see the numbers are increasing, but are they increasing by the same amount? So I notice it's increasing by 7, by 7, by 7. So this represents a constant difference of 7. So that would make f of x a function. When you look at the other ones, you can see why they would not represent a function. So from negative 1 to 1, that's an increase of 2. From 2 to 5, that's an increase of 4. So not a function anymore, because it's just not a function. It's not a constant difference, so this is not a linear function. Let's look at the next one. I have 9 to 12, so that's plus 3. And then 12 to 17 plus 5, so not a linear function. It has to be adding the same number or subtracting the same number. And the last one, you have negative 2 to 4, so that's plus 6. And then the next one is 14 plus 10. So again, no, not a function. And that's all you're looking for. You're just looking to see, is f of x creating a sequence where they're adding, increasing, or decreasing by the same amount? Let's look at this next example, and we're looking for situations that can be modeled by a linear function. So the only one that shows a linear function would be C. And why is it linear? Because it's literally written in that AX plus B form, where we can see a constant rate. So look at number C, letter C. Cell phone company charges a base amount plus 20 cents per minute. So imagine the base amount is, let's say, $100 plus 20 cents, so 0.20x per minute. Every single minute that goes by, you're adding another 20 cents each and every time. So this would create my constant difference. My constant is 20 cents per minute. I can see it, I can recognize it. Every other example here has a key word, or in the situation, that tells me it's not linear. So for example, in A, the reason it's not linear is because it is compounded annually. And that means that the rate is adding onto itself each time. It's getting bigger and bigger and bigger. So in the first year, let's say you have $100, and you get, after a year, it's 5%, so that's 105. And the next year, I want 5% of this number. So I'm not adding just $5 anymore. I have to add 5% of the whole 105. So it's changing every single year. And that would not be linear. So after a while, if it keeps increasing a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more, you're gonna get a curved line, not linear. In B, the bacteria is doubling. So when you see words like doubling or tripling, I know that this is multiplying, like it's getting exponentially growing fast. It's rapid growth, rapid decay. So think about your numbers. If I go from 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, that's a doubling pattern. And that is not a constant difference. So times 2 is not the same thing as plus 2. And in D, it's telling me a decay by a factor of 1/3. That's the key word. So decay by a factor. So that's automatically telling me I'm multiplying by 1/3. So my numbers are getting smaller and smaller. I'm dividing by 3 each time. It's repeated division. So that's not linear. All right, so those are the keywords you're looking for. And in today's lesson, you're going to look for any situation that is linear that somehow represents a rate similar to this. It's AX plus B, where there's a constant rate and maybe a constant on the end. So let's do a guided practice. Hit pause, try and identify of these 4 tables, which one of them represents a linear relationship. Look for that constant difference. All right, let's do the reveal. And the answer is C. C is the only one that has a constant difference, and our difference is equal to 2, positive 2. And so if you looked at all your numbers, each time you're adding 2, and that's what would make this one a linear relationship. All my other ones have a different one. So here it's starting by plus 1, then plus 2, then plus 5. So nope. My numbers keep on changing. So this one actually, it went from plus 1 to plus 3 to plus 5 to plus 7. So there's an odd number pattern, but that's not linear. In B, just the first one tells me it's increasing by 1/2, and then by 1, and then by 2, and then by 4. So this is a doubling, nice doubling pattern. It is a pattern. It's a doubling one, but it's not linear. And here it's increasing by 1. It's increasing by 1. Hopeful is so close, but what happens here? Increases by 7. And then it increases by 19. So be aware, it may start off looking linear, like a constant difference, but when you keep on going, it is not true for every single one. So hit pause and jot this down into your notes. And again, this is just going to be you recognizing, do you see a pattern happening with addition and subtraction that is consistent? That's it for today's lesson. I'll see you in the next one. Be well.